Hello, my friends. This is Lex Dominion. God gave me a unique word for you this afternoon. This word will change your life and how you see yourself and your perception about the world, the whole world. The word that God gave me for you is, this is your time to unleash the greatness that is in you. There is greatness in you. When God created you, He put a seed of greatness in you. And this is the time to unleash this greatness. Nobody can do this for you. You have to do this for yourself. Maya Angelou wrote a book called I Know Why Caged Bird Sings. Think about that. I Know Why Caged Bird Sings. If you lock a bird up in a cage, the bird will start singing. What are the songs? Limitations, frustrations, unfulfillment, poverty. For many years, I lived my life like a bird locked up in a cage. But a few years ago, I refused to continue to live like that. And I intentionally destroyed that cage of limitation and frustration and hopelessness and despair. Now, I'm living my life to the fullest. I do not know. Maybe you're still living your life like a bird locked up in a cage. My question to you is, For how long you're going to stay in that cage of limitation and frustration and unfulfillment? Today is your day to intentionally destroy that cage and start living your life to the fullest. You are born for more. You are made for more. Your best days is not behind you. It's right in front of you. Anytime I talk about this, people always ask me, Lex, how can I know that there's greatness in me? Good question. And I always answer them this way. You are unique. You are unique. You are unique. This is your time to celebrate your uniqueness. This is no time to let the stinking bubbles of opinions of people neutralize, pollute, or contaminate your uniqueness. When God created you, He created you to be a masterpiece. There will never be another you. You are in a class all by yourself. You are special. You are unique. This is your time to celebrate yourself. This is your time to celebrate who you are. You are not a mistake on this earth. You have a destiny and you have a destination. And God has a great plan for your life. Many years ago, a guy walked into the downtown parking lot in Indianapolis and shot himself in the head. He committed suicide. There is another type of suicide people don't talk about. It's a suicide of imitation. People that keep imitating other people, they're going to die without identity. Please be yourself because you are unique. It is in the Bible that those who don't believe in Jesus Christ, they're going to go to hellfire. It is a fact. It's not an opinion. It's not a principle. Those who don't believe in Jesus Christ, they're going to go to hell. There's another set of people that are going to go to hellfire. It's people who keep imitating other people. Copycat. It's in the Bible. Jesus gave a parable about a master who wanted to travel and he gathered his 3 servants and gave them talents. For the purpose of what I'll be talking about, I will call that talent dollar. He gave one $5. He gave one $2. He gave one $1. The one that he gave $5 was creative. Well, he used his uniqueness to be creative and made another $5. The one he gave $2, he used his uniqueness to be creative and made another $2. But the one he gave $1 begged the money. When the master of the house came back, the one that I gave $5, he said, Master, I was creative. I used my uniqueness to be creative and I made another $5. The master was happy with him. The one he gave $2, he said, Master, I used my uniqueness to be creative and I made another $2. And the master was happy with him. But the one he gave $1, he said, Master, you are a robber. You want to reap what you've not sowed. Take your $1. And the master got mad. And the master told him that because you refuse to be creative, because you refuse to use your uniqueness to be creative, it cast him to hellfire where there'll be gnashing of teeth. If you don't want to end up like this servant who went to hell for not celebrating his uniqueness to be creative, you have to use your uniqueness to be creative and you will achieve greatness. There is greatness in you. There's greatness locked up in the basement of your soul. This is your time to unleash the greatness that Almighty God put in you. I'm going to finish with a word from President James Buchanan. He was the president before Abraham Lincoln. He said, "The test of leadership is not to put greatness into humanity, but to elicit it, for the greatness is already there." Think about that. The test of leadership is not to put greatness into humanity, but to elicit it, for the greatness is already there. I'm not here to create greatness. I'm here to show you what is already on the inside of you. I'm here to help you to elicit the greatness that is on the inside of you. The greatness is in you. This is your time to unleash the greatness that is in you. You are born for more. You are made for more. See you at the top.